Hello, everybody. It's I, Luigi Big Mac.
And I'm in Party 74.
And welcome back to Dead Rising Deluxe Remastered for quite possibly the last time, as we are in the home stretch here. We are level 48, nearly level 49, and we're going to give Isabella this last queen. There we go. And we're going to...
We have all of the queens. There's no turning back. Make sure you have enough weapons and food with you.
Let's see.
Are you absolutely sure?
Dang, it actually gives us an option.
Yep, that's good, but we already have prepared ahead of time. Because we have...
The original didn't give us an option. You either had your shit ready, or you ended up with an entire thing of queens and then didn't have anything for it.
Yep, but we have three machine guns. We grabbed the katana just for, like, melee combat, which isn't going to be a problem, because if the katana breaks, we can still just disembowel zombies or special forces or anything. Or
at least I won't have to worry about turning into one of them for a while.
Or, like, you know, any of those things. So we're more than capable.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Next on the agenda. Figure out a way to get the hell out of here.
While I was isolating the hormone, I managed to identify a pheromone that suppresses the attack instinct in adult parasites. In other words, the zombies don't like the way it smells.
Oh, we have stinky fart gas for zombies.
Give me a little more time. I should be able to produce some of this pheromone.
They think it smells bad? You think we could use something like that to keep them away from us? We could just walk right past them and get out of here.
In theory, yes. Either way, it's certainly better than nothing.
There was a cave. Outside, where the helicopter crashed. It was packed with zombies. I mean, shoulder to shoulder. But it may lead somewhere outside.
It's our best shot.
If it works, your anti-zombie perfume, it could keep us safe in that cave.
Anti-zombie perfume? I prefer stinky fart gas.
What do you say? You ready to get the hell out of here?
There won't be enough of this pheromone to waste it on experiments. We'll only have enough to use it once.
Whatever you say.
Alrighty. Now, I don't remember. Does it automatically take us to the cave? Or do we have to escort Isabella there ourselves? Which, if that's the case, you're going to see us disembowel some more special forces. Okay, no, it takes us to the cave automatically.
My god. There are so many.
To no man's land. I don't know.
How many of them keep pouring out of here? It must be connected to something. Isabella, look. Any other way out of here is guarded by the military. If we're gonna get out of here and put a stop to Carlito's plan, we've got to go in there. It's the only way. It's not like we're unarmed. We've got your smelly perfume, don't we?
The stinky fart gas.
I wouldn't be alive right now if your shot hadn't worked. The perfume's gonna work too. I know it.
All right. Let's go.
Now... Yeah. Now, I wonder, is she still going to hold a lantern that just keeps zombies away? Or is Isabella just anti-zombie?
I guess we'll see.
Also, technically, we don't have to worry about turning into a zombie now. Also, we can save here. So, I think for safety's sake, we're going to save.
Yeah.
And that's it for today's episode. Nah, just kidding. Alright. They call me the Katana Master. Oh, Jesus Christ. Nearly,
Yeah, let's try not to accidentally stab Isabella.
Yep, so now we have to let Isabella through here. I'm gonna keep using this until it breaks.
And I'm already broke.
Hey, we got the wrestling boots.
Might as well grab that queen as soon as you disembowel the bunch of zombies.
God, I love the new input for this.
It makes it so easy to do.
Yep. Okay, this will allow us to just run through these assholes. Oh shit, they added a pickaxe here we can grab.
Ooh. Make sure Isabella's doing okay.
She has a stinky forecast. She's fine. And I'm fine too, because I just have to keep holding right bumper in the A button. I like how Sarah Eagle just keeps shifting. Okay. If there's ever a time for zombie ride, now's the time.
It's now, and you can get the achievement for it. But there you go.
Yep. Oh, jeez, I can't, double layer is also a really useful thing to have here. Hopefully Isabella teleports with us. Isabella?
Isabella.
Okay, don't worry, she's fine. Follow me. Over here, Isabella. We have a door we have to go through. Yeah, I mean, like, I wasn't too concerned about Isabella because she has a stinky fart gas, so the zombies can't really hurt her if they even if they wanted to.
I know. For a split second, though, I thought we couldn't get back up there.
Yeah, no, don't worry. Yeah, if anything, this is probably the easiest way of dealing with the zombies. Just grab Isabella's hand and just run through a lot of them. Mm-hmm. Let her through, and then we have a lot of fun.
Here we go.
Level 49. We are... Oops. Well, fuck that guy in particular. Okay, where are you, Isabella? There we go. And then we just gotta walk through this lonely road full of zombies.
Up to the end.
Yep.
We get our last official
Ozzy,
save.
Yeah,
as far as we know.
Yeah, Ozzy, this is...
Unless they change...
Because in the original, if you die in the next section, you have to redo, like, the entire thing over again. It's two parts.
The entire two things of the last section. Right here is a save.
If we can get that gate open, they'll be too busy dealing with zombies to notice us slip by.
Wait. The pheromone is starting to wear off.
Oh no,
this... It's only strong enough to cover one of us.
The stinky fart gas.
What are you...
Alright, hang on tight, okay? Once we're out, let's see if we can't steal ourselves that set of wheels.
We're gonna be the one stealing the military vehicle and
Save.
No!
Save. Oops. Save.
All right.
You don't want to forget to save. I don't want to have to go through zombies again.
I'm just gonna overwrite this one. Okay, now the zombies can. Okay, excuse me. Here, you can eat that. And then we just have to head over here. Excuse me, game. Can I? Oh, I have to put her down.
You have to put her down. Excuse me, game.
What kind of bullshit's that, game?
Excuse me, game.
Okay, hold on. Go. You stay right there. God.
Come on.
Ooh, we can go. Ooh, we can go a bit further down here.
Oh, yep, this is the. Found him. I've located it.
Wow, these zombies suck.
We should probably heal before we.
Well, yeah, sure. Let's just drink one of these.
Just careful with the camera angle.
Don't worry, you're fine. Trust me. And just like that. So how do you guys feel about on-rail shooters? Also, notice how Isabella was in the passenger seat right before the cutscene loaded in.
Whoa!
Alright, well, wonder why this gun that Isabella has is so powerful. Because it can fucking destroy the-
Oh my god! That is way more than the original.
Yep, yep. No, this thing is a fucking tank. Literally. I was referring to the gun, not the actual goddamn tank.
Yeah, oh my god, this is way easier than the original.
Don't worry, guys, we're fine. We just have to. All you have to do is just shoot the headlights, honestly.
That was extremely quick. I was expecting that to last longer.
These automated machines are no use at all on the battlefield. Switch to manual control.
Imagine if we have to do it again now.
Oh god.
You know, far away, he kind of looks like a dork.
Aim main cannon. Oh shit. Well, what have we here? Where were you hiding when my men mopped up the mall? On a mission in which the number of targets is unclear, it's difficult to ensure absolute thoroughness.
You know, I don't care what you're saying right now. You're literally trying to cover this up.
That's what drives you in your quest to run. Your quest to hide.
And my quest to expose all the government's secrets.
Prey, you and your kind are much more stubborn than the zombies.
I'm literally going to disembowel you.
How much do you know about the zombies? I commanded the Santa Cabeza cleanup operation.
Oh, now we know this guy is a piece of work.
If we had fulfilled our mission then, we wouldn't be needed here now to take care of this incident.
That's all it was to you, huh? A mission. What about those innocent people who had to pay for sins committed by our government?
Our mistakes have not begun with this operation. Humanity has proven itself to be quite adept at making mistakes.
You know what his big mistake is?
Hell, what's that?
It's the only thing we truly excel at.
We'll wait. We'll see in just a moment.
Well, then, I'd say this mission isn't quite over yet. Don't you agree?
His big mistake is not firing the cannon on Frank.
Oh, yeah, true.
Because now he got close enough to be able to beat him up.
And we're dressed as the Boulder Man.
Yeah. Yeah. Don't you know we punch boulders for a living, pal? So, in this fight, no healing. No weapons.
Is that all, tough guy?
Oh, Jesus Christ. He's still a bitch.
Oh, they out!
Oh. You don't stand a chance, kid. Yeah, our best move in the original was the double Larix. You could win the entire fight with just the double Larix. We are getting our ass whooped, though.
And so will the truth.
Oh, God.
Oh, damn it! Well, they definitely made this fight a lot more difficult.
But they added, like, button press prompt to kick his ass.
It's pointless to resist.
Oh!
Oh my! Yes! Yes! Okay, they made that fight a lot more exciting than in the original. Yep. They still kept that stupid scene of the close-up of his face as he falls into the zombies. Although this time, he's smiling. Like the smug prick he is. Almost like Geese fucking Howard from Fatal Fury. Yep. Wow, that whole segment took about 20 minutes.
Oh my god. I mean, I was expecting this to take us a while, you know, because the original game takes 500 years to get that damn tank section done, and then takes 500 years to hope that you beat them.
Yeah, but that fight's no joke, because Double Larry doesn't do a whole lot like what he used to. Then again, I think the only reason why Double Larry was the best move to use in the original probably had to do with the fact that the AI is a bit wonky in that game. So, because his AI is a bit wonky, you get him stuck at a section to either spam a knee drop or Double Larry. Honestly, I think knee drop is probably your... I think the somersault kick and the knee drop is probably your best... I think those two moves are your best damage dealers for this fight. Just because they come out quick and they do decent damage.
Yeah, that is the end.
Yeah, that's the end of Dead...
I wasn't expecting this to go by quicker. That so quick. The original game took so long with the ending.
Yeah, and that's just... Then again, we've played the original a decent amount. Or at least I have. But like I've kind of know what I'm getting into, so I kind of know all the good stuff. Overall, yeah. I think this I think I enjoyed this remaster over the original. Like, don't get me wrong, I love the original. But the thing that was always frustrating were the survivors, because the survivors just never listened. Like, the amount of times I was screaming at a survivor in this game was a lot less compared if I was playing the original.
Yeah, it's like we had a couple stinkers, but you know, that was just either time management or a horrible timing.
Yep. But
other than that, like we did pretty decent with saving the survivors.
Yeah, we only missed about
the same could not be said if we were playing the original.
Yeah, we were playing the original, not even half of them would have been alive.
Yes.
Yep.
Yeah.
And then they still kept the end credits the same, where it's just a giant line of zombies walking as the credits are rolling.
That's still pretty cool though.
Yeah. It's pretty cool looking, but it is kind of funny that that's just all that's playing during the ending. A really rad song.
And that's probably copyright claimed.
Oh yeah. This video is going to get copyrighted just because of the
end credits.
But you know what? It's fine. I'm not making money off of YouTube. I don't trust YouTube at their current state at the moment. That might change in the future, but even then, this is mainly, if I were to earn money from YouTube, it would just be like just pocket money. I won't be relying on it just to pay bills. Considering like other YouTubers like I like to watch every now and then, like Phantom Strider, for example, recently announced retirement. Not because he feels like he no longer wants to do it, or like has a family he has to take care of, but he just can't pay his bills with all the YouTube money anymore.
Yeah.
And that kind of says a lot about what's going on in the world right now.
Yeah.
That and YouTube. YouTube
is a mess.
YouTube, but like my main thing about YouTube is that they play favorites.
Yeah.
But we're
almost at the end of the credits, so luckily we won. Well, actually, I don't think we're over it. I thought we were at the end of the credits for a second. For the most part, this was still a good, like, remaster, and I'm hoping that they do end up doing Dead Rising 2.
Yeah, because I want to be able to play Dead Rising 2 with a controller, not have to find controller inputs through Steam input, or have to borrow Kylie's copy for 360. And keep in mind that the 360 marketplace is at this point just completely done. So she can't even get Case West or Case Zero for Dead Rising 2.
Unless
Frank West managed to escape the town of Willamette with information pertinent to the incident under his belt. The news caused a fervor throughout the world, leading the U.S. government to admit at least partial culpability in the livestock incident. However, no connection to the Willamette incident was acknowledged, and the events that occurred there were deemed the work of a fringe terrorist group. The people of the world, as could be expected from the modern culture of news saturation, soon let the Willamette incident fade from their minds. The authenticity of Carlito's chilling plan to utilize the orphans as his pawns has yet to be confirmed or proven false. And yet he complained that his belly was not full.
Yeah, Frank will never truly be the same.
And now we have unlocked Infinity Mode. And we're going to save this right here. And now, you think we would probably end off the episode, but I've heard that the Infinity Mode is actually different.
So, we might as well show a little bit of Infinity Mode, since we have a decent amount of time. This took a lot less time than we thought it was going to.
We are going to carry over Frank from from the end here. So, how many days can you survive in the shopping mall that's becoming Living Hell? Life bar, okay, so they still have the life bar draining slowly as time goes on. Pay careful attention to this as you progress and try to survive as long as you can. You can suspend this mode by selecting Suspend Infinity Mode from the pause menu. Consider anyone be your enemy. That's the other thing to Infinity Mode. Any survivor you find, whether they used to be a foe or ally, will now try and kill you. All the enemies may drop items when defeated. Your rival's locations will be indicated on the map, so be proactive. So, basically, you want to kill survivors. I know in the original, survivors will actually, die. Or they will stop spawning after a certain amount. What outfit should we wear now?
Might as well show off an outfit we haven't seen yet.
What? The goddamn Blodia from Cyberbots. Now, unfortunately, the blender's not here. And you can actually go through here now. But first, if we go through here, please tell me he's still here. Oh, you're here.
Oh, God.
Normally, you don't spawn. Okay.
Jesus Christ. Yeah, this is not the person that usually spawns up on this roof.
Okay, I was not expecting Joe to be here.
I wonder if they randomized all the people that,
Well, I know Joe does like to spawn in this location at some point, and we died. Excellent.
Well, that's the episode.
Yeah, no, we're gonna try this again as we, dick around a bit more. Start game. Yeah, because I'm assuming.
Because that's usually not the first person to survive to spawn up there.
Let's see. Oh, we. Okay. Hold on. New game. And then we can choose this, and then we can start over again. But, yeah, so
both. Take two.
Okay, take two. This time, let's not go out there. Because I was low-key hoping that Otis was going to spawn. Because in the original, as soon as you went out there, to signify that anyone can attack you, Otis would be the one attacking you. So, I wonder if you go through here, he'll be the one that'll be attacking you. And for the most part, zombies do show up in the mall, last time I recall. I don't think Special Forces do until... They either show up much later or they don't show up at all.
I haven't played much as Infinity Mode.
You can also take some pictures as well, so... let's see... You know what I wonder? Are you supposed to take a picture of this from here? No. I still don't know how you're supposed to take the picture of that PP,
Well, I don't know if the PP stickers are...
On right now? Yeah, that's the other thing.
If anything, that's probably the spot you could have had taken it.
Probably. But we just didn't have the time to be able to do it.
Yeah, plus we got the Special Forces up our ass.
Yep. Hey, sometimes they, drop stuff. Wait, what?
Already?
You know what? No, fuck this. Let's go fucking kill Joe.
Might as well.
Fuck yeah. Yeah, fuck yeah. Let's go fucking kill Joe with this. Watch as we go out there, it's Otis instead.
That'd be funny as hell.
Also, this looks completely normal, by the way. We're a giant mech with a giant fucking gun. What the?
Hello?
What the fuck?
See, they knew you were coming armed, so they're like, you know what, we're not gonna give you Joe. We're gonna give you no one.
Is everything randomized now? I mean, you see a bunch of zombies.
Jeez.
I also. Okay. First thing first. Bad zombie. Taking this handgun and then. Give me my fucking heavy rifle here. What are the odds we walk out here and fucking Kent shows up?
I would kill him.
Yeah. Immediately. Oh man, I can't wait to play through this and create the heavy machine gun through a blender. Just to obliterate Joe immediately. Or not Joe, fucking...
Okay.
Kent, yeah.
Yeah, we do have to find someone because we're gonna need some food in a little bit.
Yeah, so far I have yet to find anyone other than Joe that first time, and even them.
Joe whooped our ass.
Yep. A bit unfair, don't you think, to give us a mid-game... psychopath when we have nothing. You know what? Yeah, it's like... Yeah, because I'm walking around right now. I don't see any survivors or anything. Actually, maybe we're supposed to check on the map to see. I think they mentioned that you can check the map. Open map. Okay, Paradise. Okay, there's someone in Paradise Plaza, apparently. Okay, let's turn around and...
Maybe they were upstairs.
Probably. Yeah, let's go back and try and kill them. You know what? It might be fucking Kent.
Oh, that'd be funny.
Yeah, and if I recall correctly, you cannot pick up food from any sources you will normally find food. Either that, or you can only do it once. No, all I see is a bunch of zombies. Okay, then where the fuck is this person? Oh, someone's at the heliport. Well then. Okay. They should have known better than to shoot at me. Okay, watch that show shows up now. Nope.
He just really didn't like you that first run.
I guess. Like, I guess this is the game saying, "Welcome to Infinity, motherfucker!" Let's see. I recall in the original that only one character shows up in the heliport. Yep, it's this guy. He usually... I'll get rid of all these zombies here. And
just... we kick her off again, bitch.
Yep. And because he's a boss, he actually gives you a lot of good items. Coffee creamer, painting not so much, but quick step. This is the only way you can get mixed drinks, by the way, because there are no blenders. So with this, we can now figure out where another person might be. Okay, so there is someone upstairs somewhere. So there's two people in Paradise Plaza. I have yet to find them, so they might be hiding in one of the shops. It seems like they changed up how... I think they made everything randomized. Because if I recall correctly... Because if I recall correctly, in the original, Brock doesn't show up until, like, day five of, Infinity Mode. So now it seems like any survivor can show up at any time. I am sick and tired of these fucking cop zombies.
Always fucking shooting before... before you even get up to them.
These guys need to learn to fuck off. You know, there's one thing I'm curious about. Can you disembowel survivors?
Survivor, maybe.
Because you probably can't disembowel bosses. Now there is supposed to be someone in this area somewhere. There we go. Okay, no one's right here. No one in the CD shop. Yeah, I still don't see anyone here in Paradise Plaza, so...
they're somewhere.
Yeah, they are somewhere, so... and there's someone upstairs as well somewhere. Watch it! Watch. It's probably the fat man inside Joe's sandwich. Guess not.
Damn.
I don't understand. Where are all, it's saying there are survivors here, but I don't see any.
Oh, shit.
Okay, I can confirm. You cannot disembowel. You cannot disembowel survivors. Unfortunate. Holy shit, they gave us another one. Hold on, which... oh, that book is unobtainable now.
Great. Well, speaking of books, we did learn, well, because we happened to come across a video showing off the new, brand new books.
Oh, wait, no, this is the same one from before, my bad.
And turns out there's a book apparently in the gym.
Wait. No.
Oh, I think it's stuck.
Oop. Don't worry, we still got it. Okay, so...
There's a book that's in the gym that can give you all of your, like, combo attacks, like the double lariat, the...
Yeah, in the gym.
All way earlier before you even get them. Like, yeah, before you level up.
So we could have shown this about off way earlier.
We didn't even know the book.
They added a lot of new books. Like, there was one that can turn gems into fireworks. There's one that can turn... There's one that can turn... What do you call it? Oh, wait. Okay, now there's someone at the food court, so...
We have the infinitive durability one, which you get from getting 50 survivors out. There is the blender weapon one.
Yeah, which you get for just beating the base game. It has to be any ending with except for the bomb one. So you gotta survive for 3 days. And hold on, I'm gonna check our challenges real quick. Because technically we technically survived 5 days. Okay, we didn't get it, which I think is odd, because you technically do survive for 5 days if you do overtime mode, but. But yeah, you get the lasers for this one. You get Arthur's boxers, Arthur from Ghosts and Goblins. But yeah, let's go fuck around for a bit, and then we're eventually gonna have to die from starvation.
Yeah.
Because we can't keep doing this forever.
Yeah. I mean, we just wanted to show this off.
Yeah, we just want to show off the Infinity Mode. The fact they can give you the convict heavy machine gun out of the boxes.
Very early.
Very early, mind you. It's kind of crazy. You know, this reminds me of, apparently there's a Dead Rising randomizer mod for the original Dead Rising. Okay, no mercy for these zombies.
I love sound effects.
Give me my gun back. Now, where is this per... I will in the best, probably Carlito.
Watch it, A.
No, it's some other jackass up here.
Oh, it's fucking Rich.
He has a fucking gun!
Yeah. And that was Rich, the one that freaking ran into this horde of zombies while we were trying to save the woman in the box.
Oh, you wanna fight me now? Fuck off. How can he hit me from right there? That seems like a tricky shot. Did he fall down or is he still up there?
No, he's down. No, he fell. That's what you get for fucking not getting yourself killed originally.
Yeah, we're just gonna heal up a bit because we're not at Hold on, we can probably take this and make this a bit stronger. No, I mean, it makes the sickle stronger, so I guess that's fine. Where's another survivor we can find that we can pick a fight with? Nowhere, huh? Great. Wow. All right, well, I guess we're gonna run around until we either I guess we're gonna run around until we either die or... or run into, like, I don't know, like, Adam or something.
I still find it funny that, that there's no mirrors on the wall anymore.
Yep. Up there, Marshall Master.
Yep, here is the book that we were talking about.
Yep, that one gives you all your, excuse you. If I'm gonna go out, but at least I'm gonna earn myself some peep from experience. Cause you can't earn yourself experience in this mode.
And it looks like they're not going to be showing off the last thing, which is Zombie Walk, which is just Frank walking like a zombie, and it
yep.
kind of makes the zombies don't attack you too much.
You know what? I might as well... might as well show this off. It's a pretty... it's, for a melee weapon, it's pretty neat.
Oh my
wait,
god.
Did it give me... it fucking gave me Steven's, fucking thing. Okay, where's my heavy machine gun? Okay.
It gave you this cart.
And a bowling ball. I ain't going out yet. I have a thing of, quick step. Of fucking course. All right. Oh my god.
I didn't give you a sledgehammer.
This is oh my god, yeah, you go really slow with this.
Yeah, they definitely changed the speed on how you can use it. Because the original was a little faster. I swear, I think carts in general were slow, were made slower in this game.
Oh,
no,
sorry, a robotic kind of voice. Yep, wait. Wait, I just realized something.
What's that?
This is a perfect opportunity for us to be doing this. I don't know. I feel like if the Infinity Mode in this one feels a bit less,
less interesting?
Yeah, it feels less interesting.
But hey, it gives you an opportunity to kill a bunch of zombies, in different ways you want.
I didn't get a decent picture.
Hard.
Or you can use this like extended purpose. Whoa, look at that front pimp go! Yeah, I mean, you can throw plates at zombies.
You get a plate, and you get a plate.
And if we were playing Dead Rising 2, this would explode in with money. Jesus.
I still find it interesting that they added the money aspect into 2.
Yep, and technically the money aspect wasn't the... The money aspect wasn't the first... Wasn't the first time the money thing was invented.
Yeah.
What, can you not run around with a parasol?
You should. You have to do it with it. Maybe hit it once, maybe don't.
That's probably what it is. There we go.
And you got raining zombies.
Yeah, that's why I wanted to do that, so I can just try and get that achievement. Yeah, I guess zombies now give you... I guess zombies can now occasionally drop items for you. Oh, I didn't realize that. I picked up a metal rod. Hold on. What the... Oh, my own arm got in the way. Alright, I guess let's go to the entrance plaza right now.
But, yeah. I definitely would never see myself fully doing the 7-day challenge.
I'm probably just gonna do it just so I can try and get all the achievements.
Yeah, I don't have the patience for it. Yeah, this definitely at least gives you a decent amount of time to, you know, try weapons that you might have not tried in the original. While you were playing, well, in the original gameplay, as you were playing, you wanted to use the most efficient weapons for playing through the story and everything.
Oh,
we got the launch.
Hold on. Time for me to have fun with this. Oh, yeah, so. So the randomizer, so I saw a video on about that randomizer mentioned. You can use a lawnmower to kill cultists.
That's funny. Yes, just mowing the tile.
Don't worry, guys. I need to. Nah. Whatever.
Can't bring it into the water. It's still efficient when you use it outside, especially when you're using it right by the door because it gets a lot of those zombies right at the door if you really need it.
Hold on. Jeez, you kick these guys really far. There we go. This is another good way to clear hordes of zombies. Just knock one down and just start swinging them like you're Wario.
Yeah.
Hey!
Excuse me, sir.
Okay, where's this guy? Yeah, I'll see. Oh, that guy freaking died. Jeez.
I guess let's get to a safe spot, see if there's any available people yet?
Let me check. Yeah, no one else has spawned so far.
Eesh. Yeah, I know the strat for doing this is just staying in a, killing as many, people as you can, stay in a decent spot, and then use your food when you get to the last one.
Hold on, I got a good idea. What are you looking at?
No, let's be.
Oh, we got Steven's card again.
Yeah, so I guess, yeah, now the zombies give off at least something. Okay, we have... The book has usage in this?
I mean, eesh. Probably because I was going around... Hold on, let me show you something. Probably because you could do this with it.
Oh, and I think it broke.
Yeah, exactly, because I was using double area with it. Yeah, I'm not sure if they removed the ability to chain those, but I know the original, you can actually chain the football tackle.
Come on, give us something good. It's a baseball game. Home run! Yep, another healing. We're hanging a little bit in there.
Alright, we got a good one, right? Oh shit, we can go down the maintenance tunnel. Oh, this seems like a good idea.
You know, it sounds like a good place to die at.
Yep, up.
Hold
up.
If we end up dying.
Please tell me we can actually, like, hop in one of these here. No? Okay. Well, give me some milk then. Not dying yet!
I was gonna say, why does it sound like there's explosion, but I realize it's every time you jump.
Yep.
It has that explosion sound. Which makes sense, because it's
yep.
I still love all the different suits that you can wear. They're all really cool, and it's nice that they even have their own music that you can turn on if you want.
Yep. Personal favorite is the Resident Evil save theme. It's just so calming. Alright, no weapons, no healing.
No healing is no weapon.
We're just gonna keep going, just killing zombies.
And test our luck, and then as soon as we die, I think that'll
be it. Yeah, that'll do it for this episode.
And technically the series.
Yep. For now, we're probably gonna do more Dead Rising games eventually. Not in the near future at the moment. Not too big on doing like a game sequel right after, or very close to after doing the original, A car!
A car!
Fuck yeah.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
We're gonna die to starvation.
While we're driving.
Yep. Hey, where are all the zombies at?
They were like, oh, no, you got a car now. You know what? We're not gonna give you, we're not gonna give you any zombies now.
Here's all the zombies. Yeah, at least these zombies aren't like the ones in Dead Rising 3 where they can actually get themselves stuck on the vehicle. It causes your vehicle to slow down or even cause it to explode.
Yeah. Well, vehicles were very different in that game as well. But, you know, I can't wait to see those. I've still never played Dead Rising 3. I've only played through the original. I played a little bit of this remake. I just gave it a break. Because I was annoyed with the PlayStation version of this game.
Yeah, PS5 version seems like really, really... It seems a lot more messed up compared to this version here.
Yeah, I'll have to take a look and see if... take a look at it in a couple days, see if maybe I was just doing something wrong, or I'll probably just reset and go from there and see. But I've also started to... But I haven't gotten that far into 2. I've only gotten to, like, maybe the first... getting Zombrex thing. But yeah. I've heard 3 is good. I heard everything about 4 being absolute bullshit.
Imagine trying to drive a car like this. Like...
That would be horrifying. Hello?
Good, you can spam it.
Any second now.
Yeah, we're on our last life. We have about half of our life left. We're gonna die while in the side of it. I hope the car just explodes when our life is completely done. Like you just suddenly get a heart attack, go whoa, you just crash and die.
You just popped right out of the car.
6 hours. Yep. We killed at least a psychopath, and we killed 2 survivors.
Well,
that's it for this Let's Play, folks.
It was a pleasure joining in.
Yep, and don't worry, folks. She'll be returning. She'll be returning again. Don't know when though.
We'll have to see.
We will have to see. Well, if you guys enjoyed this episode and this Let's Play, please consider subscribing, as we will really appreciate it, as it'll help our channel grow. And I do content like this all the time, so yeah, if you enjoyed this Let's Play, just stick around. Besides, you might want to see me play Dead Rising 2 at some point.
Who knows, by the time we decide to play it, maybe they'll have the remastered version of that.
Most likely. And, be sure to leave a like and comment on the video so it can get pushed on the algorithm. So more people can, you know, kind of see it. Sure, it's like the last episode, but maybe someone might like the commentary, what they're seeing, and might want to watch the whole Let's Play. With that being said, we'll see you guys in the next Let's Play. As for what it is, I don't know. Yeah, I haven't decided. I mean, as of the time this video is going to be uploaded, Phoenix Wright's still going to be going for Sunday. So I don't know what I'm replacing this Let's Play with for Wednesdays.
Yeah, we'll figure that out.
Yep. I mean, if need be, I could just extend Phoenix Wright to be 2 days, since that Let's Play is going to take like a whole year to upload.
Yeah, it is a long one.
Yeah. Yeah, like 30 episodes or something like that. I upload... Actually, it might take up a whole month, honestly. One episode per... More like 3 months, honestly. Or half a year. Like, I don't know how long it's going to take, but yeah, that one's not going...
We'll figure it out.
We'll figure it out. With that being said, I hope to see you guys in the next Let's Play. Until then, have a good one, folks.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.